This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we're going to go shopping at the Big Lots to share with you guys what they have that will allow you to grow more food at home and maybe even start your season now. Depending on where you live, you may still even have snow outside or maybe still be getting cold and frosting at night. But by using some kind of greenhouses and protection, you can start your season a little bit earlier, which means you're going to expand your growing season, which means you're going to be harvesting more food and eating out of your garden instead of actually out of the Big Lots or your local grocery store. So I know some people don't like these episodes where I show the products you can buy, because in general I feel that you shouldn't need to buy any products at garden, and by all means you don't have to, but some products, I think if they're gonna allow you to grow more food, it's definitely better to buy those so that you could grow your food instead of buying your groceries. So anyways, let's go inside the Big Lots and check it out. At Big Lots, you get what you pay for, you know? And I mean, they have these small little shovels here that I like for raised beds a lot, but you know, Craftsman also sells these, and the Craftsman one comes with a lifetime warranty. Actually, this one, it's actually quite loose. So a lot of the items I don't recommend at Big Lots, but what I'm gonna do today is show you some actually good items that they do offer here that may help you grow more food at home. But first, let's take a look at these guys right here. These are basically sprayers. So it says on here, these are used for herbicides, insecticides, or fertilizers. And this is a small size, like I think it's like a 1 gallon, and here's a 2 gallon. It's just $10 and $14 respectively. Now these guys are great, not for using conventional fertilizers, insecticides, but using natural things. So I would encourage you to buy concentrated natural pest controls like neem oil. You'll have to dilute your neem oil like 1 tablespoon to like 1 gallon, and then you'll use this to spray it out. This can also be very useful for your compost tea. So you're gonna make your compost tea and then you're gonna foliar feed. Now what does foliar feed mean? That means feed through the leaves. Did you know that we can absorb nutrients through our skin, and so can the plants? Just like they have transdermal patches to put on for vitamins for us, you know, the plants absorb things through the leaves. And so you could put in your compost teas and the sprayer, things such as calcium to feed your plants calcium directly into the leaves so that they go right in, and your plants are gonna be healthier. So you're gonna need a sprayer such as this. Basically, you get the sprayer, you put in your mixture, you pump it up, it pressurizes it, then you just basically spray it out. So definitely recommend these guys. These are some major brands. Actually, this is the one I actually own at home. It has a little filter, and it's made by Chapin Company. So these guys have been making sprayers for a long time. So definitely a good price here. Another item they have that may help you, and I don't recommend this necessarily, but you know, if you're starting to garden out and you don't want to get into drip irrigation, the soaker hose is going to work. Now, soaker hoses, in my opinion, are much better than overhead spraying, but I like the drip, or even the earth mister setup that's even going to save more water than a soaker hose. So think, when gardening, good, better, best, always try to do the best you can. And if you can't afford things at other places, well then you could get this stuff, and at least you'll be growing some food. And that's my whole message today. Another thing they have here at Big Lots are these nice large pots. So these pots right here, $14. I mean, when you're buying a pot for growing food at home, you want to get the largest diameter pot as possible. So this one's actually fairly wide. You know, something like this would not be as good because it's not quite as wide. You want to give your plants room to grow. So the more basically area you have on the top, the more you could plant in it. In addition, besides this $14 guy, they got these guys, which are $20, and these are imitation wine barrels, which you would need to put some holes in. And you know, if we take a look at the area of both of these, they're actually about the same. So you could get the $14 one or the $20 one, but this one actually has a nice plastic smell. And I would encourage you to use real wine barrels instead of the plastic ones. Real wine barrels may be able to find on Craigslist or at nursery and garden centers. And they're just gonna cost you, depending on where you live, a little bit more than $20. And you know, they're gonna last a lot longer, in my opinion, and just, it's more sustainable. And it's real wood. Now we're in the pool area, and check it out. Here's like a little kid's swimming pool, but guess what? This will also hold some dirt, pop some holes in the bottom, and you could grow a raised bed garden in a swimming pool. Now this thing is 18 bucks, and you know, I don't know, it might not be good if you don't have kids, but you could fill this up with some dirt and easily plant a square foot raised bed garden in it, and even put it over things like concrete. So, you know, there's a lot of resources and things you can use that'll hold dirt here, and swimming pools are just one of them. Anyways, next let's head over and check out the real raised bed kits here at the Big Lots. Another thing they have here, just like last year's, they have the Rays bed kits. And here's their Rays bed kit they have here this year. It's the Wilson and Fisher 4-foot Rays bed garden kit. So this is basically a 4x4 Rays bed kit. And it's $30 this year. So for $30, I recommend actually don't buy this kit. This is a very small kit, and I recommend you buy a kit maybe like at the Home Depot or Lowe's where it's gonna look better. Well, I don't like the raised bed garden kit. You know, once again, if you're handy, you could just buy some wood and make your own, so it's real simple. But what I do like is something that they make it easy so that you can start growing earlier. And what this is the 4-foot by 4-foot garden bed cover. Now, I've never seen one of these sold separately for this inexpensive. This is a $20 item, and you can see here they got the raised bed, which is not included, but what is included is this framing. So they give you some framing and a special, I think it's probably a vinyl cover to go over your raised bed. It says it's easy to assemble and no tools are required. The overall size is 50 inches by 50 inches, so that'll span a 4-foot by 4-foot bed, by 36 inches, so that'll basically give, it's like 3 feet tall. So this is an amazing deal for $20. This will allow you to plant your starts a little bit earlier. This will give you a few degrees of protection if in your area it's still frosting, gets a little bit cold. Just a little bit of cover like this will actually go a long way to allow you to grow a little bit earlier. And when you start your plants earlier, that means you're gonna be harvesting earlier and harvesting more food throughout the whole growing season. So I definitely like this item a lot. Now, once again, you know, you get what you pay for. 20 bucks, this thing is probably gonna last you a season. I could see the vinyl basically getting degraded by the UV and the sun and stuff. But maybe if you contact the company, they'll be able to sell you like another cover for next year. Another thing they have at Big Lots this year are the topsy-turvy upside down planters. Now, I don't necessarily recommend these, but for a dollar, you might wanna try it. This is the upside down hummingbird hangout planter. And this is to grow like flowers for hummingbirds, but practically you could grow anything in here. It's just they're basically upside down setup and you could put any plant in there. If you do want to get the strawberry planter, they have that also. That's $250, and this allows you to grow many strawberry plants in one upside down planter. In addition, they also have the tomato planter, and that's $250 also. So these are some of the lowest prices that I've seen. Another item they have here at Big Lots, which is like the best price I've ever seen on this. This is the topsy-turvy tomato tree. And what this is, basically this is a stand that they give you. So it just basically stands 5 feet off the ground and will support their topsy-turvy upside down tomato grower. So for $15, all you need to buy is this, your soil, your tomato plants, put it in there and just put it on your deck or your patio. And remember to keep it watered. The topsy-turvies, because they are hanging out, tend to absorb a lot of sun, which means the water will evaporate and you'll need to water a little bit more often than you would for plants in the ground. One of the items that they have this year is actually they have a whole section for seed starting. Now, they're not really selling any seeds here, but they're selling the items you need to grow your own if you start your own seed. So here's some little peat pots, a dollar, you know, so you get 10 little peat pots right here for a dollar, so that's 10 cents each. That's an amazing deal. Now, if you are starting your plants in the peat pots, once you're gonna transplant them, I recommend taking off the peat pots and don't plant them in the peat pots. While you can plant them in the peat pots, roots have a hard time going through the peat pots and may confine your roots, which will then mean your plants will be confined and not grow or yield as much for you guys. Next thing I wanna show you guys is a 72 cell seed starter greenhouse. So this is for 72 plants. Amazing thing here, it's just $4. So you get several different parts with this. You get the standard 72 cell tray here that you're going to fill up with some seed starting mix. You get a tray right here that's not going to allow the water through, so it's not going to drip all over. And in addition, you get the plastic dome cover. Now, this plastic dome cover, if you check in nurseries, normally sells for $4 in itself. So, you know, for this kit for $4, it's absolutely a good deal. In addition, they got some more 8-cell peat strips, and this is basically 24 plants, $250. In here, in addition, if you don't want to do the 72 plant thing, you could do a 25 peat pellet greenhouse. So this has the peat pellets pre-installed with the little greenhouse top for $4. So I've never actually seen this product any cheaper than this. So if it's gonna let you grow some more food, definitely worth it. But if you're not gonna grow 25 plants, you could just get one of these guys. This is a Sow and Grow 10 peat pellet greenhouse for $2.50. Now this isn't quite as good of a deal as the other one, but nonetheless, if you're gonna grow just a few plants, this is definitely good. And I'm happy that Big Lots is making these available so that people can start growing their own food today. The last thing I'm gonna show you guys today are the greenhouses. I did an episode about this last year, and I think, you know, for the prices here, they're amazing. It's the lowest prices I've seen on these kinds of greenhouse kits anywhere. And you can see here, it says, greenhouses, grow it yourself. And in this picture, they actually have a nice large greenhouse, and I don't see that one here. I don't know if it's sold out or, you know, they don't have any more, but that would be cool. It'd probably be a really good price. But what they do have are a few smaller greenhouses. So this is a three-tier greenhouse with solar spotlights. This is about 48 inches high, 11.6 inches deep, and 26.5 wide. This one has some solar lighting, which I'm not a big fan of. This is the good deal right here, though. This is $30, and it's a four-tier greenhouse. Now, once again, this is only for starting your plants, like on a patio, to keep them a little bit warmer. Or, you know, you wouldn't want to put this out in the middle of a field. This is also good for using actually inside your home to basically zip it up to keep it a more humid and moist environment, although you may need to put supplemental lighting on. Of course, they also have the $20 version, which is a three-tier, so that's just a lot smaller, but $20 is definitely a good price for a seed propagation and plant growing greenhouse. Now, this does come with a PVC cover with front zipper closure on all these models. And the cool thing I found this time is that they're selling a replacement greenhouse cover for the $20 one. You know, it's a small one. So if you bought this last year, you could just find the new cover for it if yours did degrade. And they're only $7. So I'm confident that they may also have these covers for these other model greenhouses, as well as that raised garden cover that we also just saw. So hopefully you guys learned about a few of the items that Big Lots has that may allow you to grow more food at home, and especially these guys, the greenhouses, you know, because it can be a kind of a pain in the butt to make your own covers, but when it's already pre-made for this inexpensive, I mean, it's pretty much a no-brainer. You should just go ahead and do it so you could get your plants in the ground earlier so they could be harvesting your food earlier and eating more of your food than food coming from the grocery store. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep on growing.